So a few quiz questions after the fashion of the TV show QI. Okay, contestants, hands on buzzers, no conferring, no saying the answer out loud. Our first question. You probably know that the heart pumps the blood around the body. An easy question to see first, you know, simple terms. All the fresh blood flows from the heart through the arteries. All the used blood flows to the heart through the veins. True or false? If you said true, stand up and take a bow. Now. If you took a bow, I guess you don't watch QI. QI is full of tricky questions where the answer most people would give is wrong. The screen flashes black and a klaxon sounds, which I simulate now. The reason you were wrong was that I said all the used blood. Not all the used blood flows back through the veins, which will become clearer when you answer the next question. Okay, contestants, hands on buzzers, no conferring, no saying the answer out loud. During the time it takes for the 5 litres of blood in your body to circulate around your body, about 10% is extracted as a clearish fluid and takes a different path. Can you name that fluid? I'll take a medical term or a less polite term as an answer. If your answer was urine or pee or piss, stand up and take a bow. That 5 or so litres of blood circulates around your body in around 1 minute. I'm afraid that if 10% of your blood every minute was destined for the toilet, very simple maths shows you would last no longer than 10 minutes. The medical term for the clearish fluid from your blood that does not flow back to your heart through the veins is lymph. I don't know any less polite terms. So, roughly speaking, your heart pumps 100% of your fresh blood through your arteries and 90% of your used blood through your veins. 10% of your used blood travels back to the heart through your lymphatic system. Okay, contestants, hands on buzzers, no conferring, no saying the answer out loud. What moves the lymph through the lymphatic system back to the heart? Pumping of the heart? Skeletal muscles, such as the muscles that move your arms and legs. Smooth muscles, similar to the muscles that move food through your bowels, along the lymphatic tubes. Muscles that you use to breathe. A series of one-way valves inside the lymphatic tubes. Did you say heart? Not the heart. Here we can see a section of the tube that the lymph flows along, a lymph vessel. That green blob in the lymph vessel is lymph, which will travel up the vessel. The pairs of blue lines are one-way valves. Here they are closed as they normally are. The red ovals either side of the tube are muscles. When these muscles contract, they will push the lymph against the one-way valves. Like this. The valves only work one way, so the bottom valve stays shut while the top valve opens to let the lymph through. When the muscles relax again, as here, the lymph is on its way. So when you squash a lymphatic tube, the lymph can only flow towards the heart. And what can squash a lymphatic tube? Your skeletal muscles, like those in your arms and legs. Your breathing muscles that move your diaphragm and in some places some special smooth muscles that just work on the lymphatic tubes. So for 4 points, you had to choose all four answers, B, C, D, and E. One time we notice the lymphatic system is when it goes wrong. If we don't work our skeletal muscles, especially arms and legs, or our breathing muscles enough, the lymph cannot flow back and collects, especially in low places. So, if you spend time as a couch potato, or trapped in an aircraft seat for a long time, you may notice the lymph collecting around your feet and ankles, making them swell. Oedema is the medical term. Another time we notice the lymphatic system is when it is doing right, when it's doing part of its job. Which brings us to our next question. Okay, hands on buzzers, no conferring, no saying the answer out loud. I went to the doctor recently and reported feeling a little off colour. The doctor put his hands on me, something like this. What was the doctor looking for? Five points if your answer had lymph nodes in it. 10 points if your answer had swollen lymph nodes in it. In around 100 places around your body, there is a bulge in the lymph vessel called a lymph node. One of the jobs of a lymph node is to help the immune system to handle infection. As it fights infection, it temporarily swells. Many lymph nodes are hidden well inside your body, but some, like those in your neck, under your armpits, or in your groin, are close enough for the doctor to feel. You can feel them yourself. If the doctor feels the lymph nodes here are swollen, he or she will perhaps be looking for a throat infection. Final question on lymph nodes. In a few places in the body, there are bunches of lymph nodes. I'm in my late 60s as I make this video, and I'll be in my early 70s when you are watching it. Okay, contestants, hands on buzzers, no conferring, no saying the answer out loud. I've lost a couple of bunches of lymph nodes. What's the most likely cause? If you said cancer, stand up and take a bow, if you dare. Certainly, if you had surgery for cancer, you may have lost some lymph nodes at that time. But take yourself a full 10 points if you said tonsils. The two bunches of lymph nodes either side of the throat are called the tonsils. Chronic infection of the tonsils is sometimes, today, dealt with by surgical removal. But when people my age were younger, tonsil removal was much more common. And that's the most likely reason people my age have lost bunches of lymph nodes. Just in case there is a newly diagnosed man with a locally advanced cancer, a T3, listening to this, who is wondering whether he has 2 weeks or 2 months ahead of him, it may help him to know this. My prostate cancer was large. It filled the right side of my prostate. It spilled into the left side. It was growing through the wall of the prostate in two places, including up and around a nearby organ, the seminal vesicles. The Gleason score of 6 out of 6 of the biopsy samples on the right side was 5 plus 4 equals 9. In all, a large, locally advanced aggressive cancer. As I make this video, that was almost 6 years ago, and my PSA is currently undetectable, so don't panic. If you are a man with advanced prostate cancer, locally advanced like me, metastatic, that is spread to other parts, or recurrent, returned after your first treatment, there is a group of men helping each other understand the disease. The Advanced Prostate Cancer Support Group offers information and online forums at JimJimJimJim.com. Again, the website is JimJimJimJim.com. That's the word Jim four times, no spaces, .com. Nothing else, just .com. JimJimJimJim.com. Thank you.